Grace and peace to you, my friends, and our Lord Jesus Christ from the office of the General Assembly, where our mission is to serve those who carry out the Great Commission. Of course, one of the ways we do that is by supporting all that it takes to pull off our annual General Assemblies. If you haven't registered for our 44th General Assembly this summer in Cordova, Tennessee, the early bird registration discount ends on May the 15th. On May the 16th, the price goes up. So up until that date, the cost is $295 per person. After that date, it's $345 per person. So we hope that you'll want to get that registration in and save that extra $50, or maybe invest that extra $50 in something kingdom-like, church planning. That's where your dollars will be multiplied, and you'll hear about all the great things God is doing through church planning at the EPC when you come to our General Assembly this summer. Until then, here's a little teaser about what God is doing through church planting in the EPC.
Church planting is a church culture, and it requires senior leaders to grab onto the vision, and in the process of seeing that vision and pressing into it, there's synergy here of folks that are carrying that, so you're not alone. And there's inspiration to take the next step according to where you are. And now I feel like I can go back and say, here's the next step forward, and gather and rally our church into the next phase.
When I think about what I learned, what God taught me during this time, first it was great just to be with other people discussing church planting. It was very encouraging to hear what's happening in the denomination. I think that the biggest takeaway for me though is we've planted a church, and now we're looking at planting another. And the idea of planting pregnant churches, planting churches that are going to plant churches, was really formational for me during this time. And the importance of sharing those stories of the way that the church plant has impacted lives. They kept talking about, how are you showing your baby pictures? How are you telling your congregation about the incredible work that God is doing in the plants that you're already a part of, so that they're thinking about what happens next? So I was really encouraged by that. I feel like it can be a great strategy for not just evangelism, but revival for our home church and for the churches we plant as well.
I just wanted to add a few words about my experience in the EPC, because you see, 27 years ago, we started Clayton Community Church in the San Francisco Bay Area of California. And back then, we were young and just learning and excited just to be a part of ministry. And this denomination put their arms around us and guided us and helped us. And now 27 years later, I really believe that it's time for us to give back. Since we started our church 27 years ago, we have helped plant 4 churches. 3 of those were actually on purpose. And because of that, we just know that there are people that church plants are going to reach that I'm not going to be able to anymore. Now, I'm not quite dead yet, but the fact is that I am just glad to be able to invest in the lives of these young church planters to do a work that our church just can't do. I mean, I think that's one of the hard things that we have to acknowledge here, is that, you know what, your church is probably doing great, but there's a whole new generation of people that need to know Jesus that someone else needs to do. And so that's why I'm going to continue to be a part of this great movement of God in our denomination. I'm going to continue to invest in church planters, whether it's financially or with my time or efforts or providing people to help them and encourage them and pray for them. That's why I want to be a part of what God is doing here, and I hope you want to be a part of it too.